Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Engineering Today. We have some updates regarding SpaceX Crew Dragon and news from Russia. So, let's get into the details. For the past 2 years, SpaceX has done many important launches in this industry. But this year, it became the first American private aerospace company which successfully launched and returned NASA astronauts to the International Space Station, ISS. That launch was under the agency's Commercial Crew Program, in which SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket launched with NASA astronauts Robert Behnken and Douglas Hurley on board in the Crew Dragon spacecraft. That mission was named Demo 2, as it was a demonstration mission to test out that the capsule is safe enough to be used in crewed space travel. The Demo 2 mission resulted successful, and after 2 months staying in the space station, both astronauts returned to Earth on August 2nd. It was a very crucial mission among SpaceX's other launches. As per that, the company gained more confidence to launch other crewed launches. After achieving success in the previous Demo 2 mission, SpaceX is now on its way to launch another crewed flight with 4 astronauts. This time it won't be a demonstration mission, as the company passed that stage. It will be a fully operational crewed mission named as Crew 1, which is scheduled to launch from LC-39A at NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida on October 23rd. The 4 astronauts that are going to ride on Crew 1 mission include 3 NASA astronauts and the 4th one from the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, JAXA. Among 3 NASA astronauts, there will be a former Crew Dragon commander, Michael Hopkins, Joint Commander Pilot Victor Glover on board, with Mission Specialist Shannon Walker. And the 4th astronaut will be the JAXA Mission Specialist Sochi Noguchi. According to the sources, the mission requires at least 6 months of time duration. As per that, Crew 1 astronauts will spend 6 months in the orbiting laboratory to perform scientific experiments in a micro-G environment. Moreover, when the Crew 1 astronauts will safely return to Earth, SpaceX will launch its 3rd crewed flight, counting from Demo 2 as the first and Crew 1 as the 2nd in the lineup. Crew 2 to the International Space Station. The 3rd crewed flight is added in SpaceX's 2021 calendar, in which the mission includes NASA astronauts Megan MacArthur and Shane Kimbrough, along with JAXA, Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, astronaut Akihiko Hoshide, and ESA, European Space Agency, astronaut Thomas Pesquet as the members. Megan MacArthur is the wife of Robert Behnken, who flew to ISS as part of NASA's previous Commercial Crew Program. Now having MacArthur for NASA's Crew 2 launch, the astronaut couple plays an important role in the agency's crewed flight launch. My wife is assigned to a SpaceX mission, and we have a young son, so I'll definitely be focused on making sure that her mission is as successful as possible, and supporting her just as she did for me, Behnken said after returning from ISS. On Wednesday, ESA astronaut Pesquet posted a photo on Twitter that shows the Crew 2 members are actively training for Mission Alpha aboard Crew Dragon. In the picture, the crew members have seen training on SpaceX's Crew Dragon simulator, which is basically used to learn various functionalities and controls of the spacecraft, with the help of 3 touchscreen displays. Pesquet said in the post, "Here's the posse together, training on SpaceX Crew Dragon, Aki Hoshide looking like a boss, and all of us wishing we had as cool socks as our awesome pilot, Astro Megan. Mission Alpha," he wrote. The picture also shows all the crew members wearing black masks as safety precautions. The interactive simulator that's used in SpaceX has an exact replica of the Dragon's cockpit. To familiarize with the cockpit's control, crew members use the touchscreen simulator for training. A week ago, Pesquet shared some photographs that shows the crew members are training on the different cockpits, which is actually the simulator. Who doesn't like cockpits? 45 years of cockpit evolution in these pictures. I'm lucky to have been at the controls of the Soyuz spacecraft, the Airbus A310, the A350, and now the SpaceX Crew Dragon, during training so far. Hashtag AvGeeks, Pesquet said in the post. Now things are getting real, and I could use your help. When going to space, astronauts are allowed a very limited amount of personal affairs. Think less than half an overhead cabin bag. Pisquette asked his Twitter followers, what would you want to see floating in space? Hashtag Mission Alpha. SpaceX also made a Crew Dragon simulation game that was released earlier this year. The simulation game is actually for players to experience a real-time scenario of how to dock Crew Dragon spacecraft to the ISS. Players will have the similar controls that astronauts use to fly a spacecraft. This game is available as the name Crew Dragon Simulator on SpaceX's website. Now let's see what's going on in Russia. The Russian Aerospace Forces, RAF, which is part of Russia's armed forces, recently launched 3 GONITS communication satellites along with a batch of 18 international small satellites as the rideshare payloads. None other than Russia's 3-stage Soyuz 2-1B carrier rocket carried this mission from the launch site number 43 of Plesetsk Cosmodrome, 800 kilometers north from Moscow. On Monday, the 28th, Soyuz 2.1 lifted off carrying the payload from the Plesetsk Cosmodrome at 11:20 UTC or 7:20 Eastern Daylight Time. For this particular mission, Russia chose the advanced 2-1B variant of the Soyuz rocket. In this lineup, Russia's Soyuz 2 is a modified version of the old Soyuz rocket. Soyuz 2.1B is kind of like the previous variant, as it uses the same booster and core stage engines, but Soyuz 2.1B offers an updated RD-0124 engine on the Block 1 second stage of the rocket. The Block 1 engine of Soyuz 2.1B rocket is more powerful than the RD-0110 engine used on the Soyuz 2.1A. Officials tested that the RD-0124 engine has a maximum specific impulse of 359 seconds, whereas RD-0110 has a specific impulse of 326 seconds. Russia previously launched all the GONETS satellite missions on its Rokot KM launch vehicles, except on the first time when it was launched on Cosmos 3M rocket. Thus, it was the first mission for Soyuz 2, 2.1B and Series 2 lineup, to launch with the GONETS M series satellites. With Monday's launch, all the rockets in Soyuz 2 lineup, which includes the Soyuz 2.1A, 2.1B and 2.1V, have flown 105 times, where only 7 faced failure and 98 of them were successful. So the company is just 2 launches away to have a total of 100 successful flights. Even the 7 rockets that failed, 4 were complete failures and 3 of them were partial failures because of some malfunctions in the optional Frigate M upper stage, not the actual Soyuz 2 rocket. The payload of the Soyuz 2.1 rocket was attached in a step-by-step process. When all the GONETS satellites, along with other 18 small sats, arrived at the targeted location, an assembly process took place. After completing integration and checkout flow, the payloads were placed on top of the Frigate M upper stage just before the encapsulation process. After that, the payloads were attached to the top of the Block 1 second stage of the rocket, and at this point, mating of the rocket was completed. Then the rocket, along with its payload, were moved horizontally to the launch site number 43 at Plesetsk Cosmodrome. The Soyuz 2.1A was mounted on the launch pad on September 25th. Previous version of GONETS work came from the Strela 3 satellites and deployed between 1992 to 2001. For the first time of carrying GONETS satellites, the rocket was utilizing the optional Frigate M upper stage for additional lift capacity while in the operational orbit. JSC satellite system GONETS operate this program, although Russian Federation Space Agency, Roscosmos, owns 51% of the company. The GONETS M satellites have a similar design with the military Rodnik communication satellites. This satellite actually stores and dump operations, which is done by uploading the data to a satellite. The satellite then stored it in its memory and after that downlinked to another user. However, this requires a permission from the Prime Minister of the Russian Federation for allowing the Russian Ministry of Defense to launch these satellites. On the 14th of September, Russian Prime Minister Mikhail Mishustin wrote a decree based on this mission to allow the Russian Ministry of Defense to use, on a contractual basis, space systems and military complexes, and involve the personnel of military units to ensure the launch from the Plesetsk Cosmodrome by the Soyuz 2 carrier rocket, Stage 1B, with the frigate upper stage of the Gonets Communication Spacecraft M, number 16, Russian Federation, and associated payload. According to the sources, the frigate M upper stage will place the Gonets satellites in 1,400-kilometer orbit, inclined 82.5 degrees towards the equator. These three satellites have serial numbers 27, 28, and 29. Now the upcoming Gonets satellites, which has a serial number of 30, 31, and 32, will be launched on the same Soyuz 2-1B on the 16th of November, 2020. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.